Hey everyone, today I want to show you a new feature we've built for our premium subscribers, the block exam subdeck feature. So the idea is simple. When you're preparing for a block exam, you can quickly build a focused subdeck from the topics you're studying without losing any of your progress in the main parent deck, in this case, the AnkiHub step deck. So here's how it works. You start in Smart Search. And so in this case, let's say I am doing a pulmonology block, and today I watched a lecture on COPD. So I'm gonna search for COPD. In this case, I'm just gonna focus on first aid and boards and beyond resources. And I'm gonna scroll through these tags, and these seem pretty reasonable for COPD. So I'll scroll down to the bottom, and instead of just the two buttons we had before, open selected in browser or add to study queue to unsuspend, I have this new option of add to block exam subdeck. So if I click that, it's gonna ask me to pick a subdeck. In this case, I wanna make a new one. And I'm going to call this, let's say, pulmonology block exam. I'm going to set a due date. That due date is when is my actual exam, when's the test, when I don't need this deck anymore. And I can choose to unsuspend these notes. And since I did watch this lecture today, I will unsuspend these notes. And I'll create that subdeck. And so at this point, I can go back to my decks view, and I will have this whole new block exam subdeck. It's treated like any other subdeck in the browser, so I can unsuspend cards, suspend cards, add things to it, etc. If, you know, the next day, let's say I watch another lecture for this block, and in this case, I'm learning, let's say, about asthma, and I want to add those two to the same deck, then I can do the same thing. I will have first aid and boards and beyond as well here. And I can scroll down, see these seem pretty reasonable. Asthma. I actually don't want any step two stuff in here, so I'll deselect that there. And I can again add to block exam subdeck. And here, since I already have that deck, I can just select it again and choose that. And I will unsuspend these notes because again, saw that lecture. I won't change my due date for the deck, and I'll add those notes. And at that point, now my block exam subdeck is even bigger. And so this is how we add to things over time, and I can just keep putting more and more content into the subdeck as I get closer and closer to my test date. Now, let's look at what happens once that test date actually arrives. So on that test date, I'm gonna see this window pop up where I can do three things. One of those things is I can set a new due date. Let's say my test was delayed for a week, something like that. I can change that due date. I can keep it, so that subdeck just will stay there as a kind of organizational thing within my parent deck forever, or I can move it to the main deck. And if I choose that, what's going to happen is it will delete the subdeck, but it's not going to delete any of those cards. It's just going to merge them back into the parent deck. My whole review history stays the same. Everything stays the same. The only thing that happens is that that deck I was using for organization while I was preparing for that exam is now bumped back into the parent deck. And that's sort of a much less threatening version of navigating subdecks than Anki's delete button, which will kill every flashcard in the subdeck forever and just delete the notes, delete the review history, everything. Also, if I want to take a subdeck I've already made and treat it like this new subdeck feature, I can just set a due date for that. Even this little instructions one, I can do that. Or I can merge those things right back into the parent deck and get rid of a subdeck that I didn't create using Smart Search, but keep all the cards within it and just bump them back into the parent deck. So this is our new subdeck feature. We think it makes exam prep way, way easier, and we'd love your feedback to make it as good as we can make it for you. Thanks so much for watching.